the 100 schools that we worked with, which were for the most part rural schools, some in sort of, you know, reasonable sized towns of 5,000-10,000 people. But you're talking about villages with no electricity, no public transport. One meal a day continues to be the norm. So extreme poverty and the education system, often, well, an important distinction is there are government recognized schools, but post the Civil War, there are many areas that still have what are called community schools.